imagine holding the latest device in the market in your hands. The one with the advanced features, the sleek design, the impressive functionalities, but the one that promised you to simplify your life. But in turn, the device is not reliable enough, it doesn't have a good battery life, and all the promises that the company made to the clients face into frustration. Now, imagine that you and your team are the ones behind this product. This highlights the fact that battery life is not just a technical specification. It is actually the device heart, usability, and efficiency, and that's why make it so important. There are three main things that underscore the importance of battery life, and these are user experience, reliability, and maintenance. The satisfaction of an end user heavily relied on for how long my device can work without the need of any kind of charging or without any kind of interruption. Whether it is a smart sensor, an IoT device, a wearable tech, a healthcare device, doesn't matter. Extended battery life means fewer disruptions and a seamless user experience. Nowadays, users just value a device that just works, that works without the need of a constant recharging or replacing batteries. And battery life also directly impacts the device reliability. A device that suddenly dies and stops working properly or stops working during a critical operation is not just an inconvenience, it is a liability. And that's why we have to ensure a long battery life in order to maintain our devices working constantly for its intended operation and also for under varying conditions. Another important factor here is that battery life also translates to higher maintenance costs over the time. These costs can be by having to send someone to a technician to a hard-to-reach location to replace some sensors or batteries, or by having your own clients, unhappy clients, replacing constantly their batteries or recharging them. And this can be either a monetary cost, but also can be a potential damage to your brand reputation. So if you're one of those who still think that battery life is not important, or is something that can be easily validated by going to the data sheet and taking some reference, I do hope that after this talk, you gain some insights in order to do power measurements that help you to deliver a high quality product. If you haven't noticed yet, power designs can be complex. And there are many hardware misconceptions around this, and some major myths about low power designs. And many believe that battery life can be easily estimated by just dividing the nominal battery capacity by the average current draw. But that the actual reason is that there is not a such thing as a nominal battery capacity, even though we can find it on the data sheets. But also, in terms of the average current draw, this is not a constant variable either. So because each use case is so unique and particular that we need to be able to measure the behavior of our device and not just rely on the standard models or on those idealized conditions. Another common myth is that power consumption is all about hardware, and this is totally not true. There are many layers of software on top of the hardware that we must be taking care of. And this is where the real complexity comes in. That is not, right now it's not a matter to just say, hey, hardware team, come and fix this. Because nowadays, all of us as developers, either if we are hardware developers, firmware developers, or software developers, all of us must be aware of how our contributions impact the overall performance of my system, and also how it impacts in terms of power consumption. So with all of this said, let's start with the three key steps that you may consider when choosing a battery for your embedded or IoT devices. So the step number one, profile your device. knowing your device and its intended usage and the environment where it's going to be deployed is essential. Because if you don't know this information, you can end up in a back and forth depending on the development approach that you are taking with your team. Because developing without having any kind of insight on what is happening from the battery life perspective can impact negatively the quality of your product, and also can extend the production time or the development time of your solution, since power design is an iterative process that must be validated since the beginning of our project until we hit the final production line. And there are various considerations that must be considered in these particular steps in order to understand what is happening in terms of the power consumption of our devices. The first is measure the device profile all the time. Make sure to measure current peaks, sleep currents, duty cycles, and everything you need to know in order to understand what is happening from the device, and also everything that you need to know in order to develop a battery-driven device. Make modifications in hardware, firmware, and software, and compare measurements. Do not make changes in your system without also measuring the power profile. This is super important, because there is always a risk that a fault can be introduced within your system. So try to always, make sure to always repeat this kind of framework. Do a measurement, do a change in your system, handle the measurement, compare it, and then optimize it. Also, use the UR functionality to understand your power profile better. During your development, you can write a print out of UR in your system, so you can actually understand what is happening from the device. So with these capabilities, you can easily determine how your code is behaving, how different functions of your code are behaving, and what of those is the one that is draining more battery from your own system. So you can understand how the software impacts the system itself. But make sure, as an important note over here, that as soon as you reach that version that it's going to production, make sure to disable UR to avoid waste unnecessary energy in the last version. And in case of working with connected devices, make sure to understand the network and protocols, make sure how the networks and protocols that you are choosing for your solution are impacting the power consumption. There are different communication technologies that offer some safe power modes, while others don't offer these power safe modes. So, and also, like some other technologies, may have good coverage while others do not, and this will rely on retransmission. So there are some trade-offs on power that need to be considered, and so constantly chosen over here in terms of connected and network protocols. Now, step number two. Now that we know our device consumption, our power profile for our device, like, what is this good for? A battery capacity provides us a lot of valuable information and insights, such as its capacity, the voltage range, the discharge rate, the temperature which can be operated in. But usually, these values are created under standardized conditions. And we cannot solely rely on this information when we are trying to create an accurate and a battery-driven device. Because the real world usage differs a lot from these standardized conditions. So that's why it's so important to profile our whole system for the conditions where it's going to be deployed. So how we do this? For this, we must profile the batteries of our system for the particular case we're planning or intended to use it. These are some of the best practices that I can share today with you, and is please don't use generic profiles for your battery profiles. Make sure to profile batteries for your specific device and for the specific device consumption data that we did in the step number one. Also, profile batteries for for a specific environment. For example, temperature is a factor that impacts a lot the battery capacity of our system. So these are things that we must consider. And also, make sure to create profiles for all the batteries that are intended to be used within your system. Because in many times, batteries from multiple manufacturers, different manufacturers, differs a lot on the results that you can get within your own system. And lastly, consider deviations like aging batteries or for how long my battery has been laying down on the shelf, or batteries that have been faced many cycles of charging and discharging, or batteries that are part of a bad batch. In many cases, power profile together with the battery chosen needs many years of battery life, and we don't have so much time to wait for when we want to validate a battery, right? So somehow we need to accelerate the discharge for this. And this is something that is super helpful because we can create an accelerated profile for discharging. In this case, here I am with the platform, you can connect, instead of connecting your device to do the device power profiles, you can replace it with the battery that you would like to use within your system. And when it's connected, here in the battery profile section, you can define the parameters of the high and low discharge based on the consumption of your device. And this can be defined either on constant power, constant current, or constant resistance. But this will depend on how your device is behaving when you are setting up this value. In addition to this, you will define the exit conditions, which will determine when your battery profile will stop, as well as additional information for the battery, such as the model, the manufacturer, size, temperature, where this battery is going to be profiled, as well as the nominal voltage. These are some things that you also need to consider when you are creating an accelerated profile. For example, some batteries and form factors are more sensitive to high discharge current, and others are not. So if you profile a battery that is sensitive, then try to keep the high discharge roughly the same that the real application consumes data. Also, cycle time can be shortened. Just make sure that the battery has enough time to recover after a pause. To increase the total discharge energy, it's wisely to also increase the sleep current consumption, but also remember to have some time to recover here after that pause. And something to highlight over here is that solution is all about corner cases rather than one typical use case in general, right? So the reason why we must consider different factors, such as how is going my device being used, where it's going to be deployed, is an indoor or an outdoor environment. If it's outdoor, in which region of the world is going to be deployed? It's not the same to deploy a battery-driven device in Sweden in the middle of a winter season than deploying it in a tropical weather such as Colombia, for example. And just be aware that it is never only one scenario, as I highlighted over here. So we must iteratively measure different corner cases. Step number three. Now that we have profiled our batteries, we have seen its performance, but how can we know if this is actually the real one that my device, my battery if this is the real battery capacity that we can extract from the battery that we just profiled? So after the profile is created, we can now emulate it in our own device that we use in the step number one. And this allows us to observe how our system behaves through its functional period and to determine how much battery capacity we can extract actually from it. Here is a quick example that basically shows how the battery emulation works. Initially, I select a power profile generated for a Wi-Fi module that was initially profiled at minus 10 degrees Celsius. Here, you will see that the result shows that under these conditions, the device cannot work properly because the system starts resetting frequently due to the fact that it's on the lower temperatures. So you can see on the UART system that the device is booting up. But when we repeat the same process and emulating this battery with another reference that was profiled at 20 degrees Celsius, we can see how the device can operate smoothly until it reaches the maximum battery capacity, which is approximately at 170 milliamps at 3.5 voltage. So this highlight and demonstrate how temperature significantly impacts the battery performance and the device stability. So that's why it's important to not just use as a reference the information that we have in our data sheet. It's important to emulate it in order to know exactly which is the percentage of the battery capacity that can be actually extracted until my device can work properly. So with all the profile created, validated, and optimized, the next step is to determine the battery life. To do this, you can simply define the battery capacity of the battery that you are using, in this case, the emulated one, and select from the graph consumption the active period of your solution and the sleep period of your solution, and the system automatically will estimate the battery life of your solution and also will give you the number of possible cycles that your solutions can handle. And after performing this battery evaluation, we could discover this result. As you can see, we got roughly 89% of the battery capacity can be extracted. So without knowing this characteristic, we will be developing at the maximum capacity of the battery that we are taking as a reference from the data sheet, but the device will not be able to work properly under that last mile and will end up rebooting constantly, right? So in this case, we got from 190 milliamps, which was the value that was provided in the data sheet, to an actual battery that was emulated to 170 milliamps. So as a quick recap of what we just covered over here, number one, profile your device. Make sure to understand how your device is behaving and how it's consuming data in order to optimize it and make it efficient. Then profile your battery for the corner use case. It's important to validate and corroborate your system for the specific specific use case where it's going to be, considering all the environment. As I just showed you, you see how the temperature impact and how with that profile that works at minus 10 degrees didn't work properly, but for the other one it works properly. That's why we have to make sure that we are validating our system for the specific use case that we are working on. And lastly, emulate the battery. In order to identify how much battery actually can be extracted for the specific behavior of our device, and also to get the precise battery capacity that you can extract in order to get a more realistic battery life. And this is a quickly reminder to you all, make sure to develop with a low power mindset. This is Maria Hernandez, Product Specialist at Goitec, and I'm looking forward to connect with you all. If you are more interested in a dedicated demo on how this tool works, how you can implement it into your development lines, feel free to jump at our booth, which is just behind this one. Thank you.